Action!
Today is the second day of the pitching sessions for the Nab'Ubomi Inter-School Short Film Competition here in Port Elizabeth. We're here at the Department of Education's auditorium where the pitching continues.
My name is Nicole Skalt.
My name is Wakazi Mnela.
I'm Norvio Masagasaga.
Sukumbuzo Nchidi. I'm from Victoria Park High School.
From Kwadwesi in Lungisa High School.
From Reiso High School in Township.
And I'm from Shortville in Port Elizabeth Patterson High School.
We're here to enter the Nab'Ubomi competition.
I'm here to represent my school, Victoria Park.
I'm here to represent my script.
I hope to achieve that young teenagers see the opportunities that we're given.
I was inspired by the children at our school and their ambition to achieve more in life.
You're going to tell us your name and what school you're from, and then we'll turn the timer over and you'll have 60 seconds to tell us your story. Okay, are you ready?
I'm here to represent our short film called Why Me?
Okay. Why you?
It's about xenophobia. They say that it's not the right thing to do.
And that is enough to make them change their minds.
And they sing a song.
Lisa is a 16-year-old girl. She finds out that she's pregnant and HIV positive. Pregnant and diagnosed HIV positive.
It's quite straight.
They have to move from the suburb to this location.
That to me I find more interesting.
If you took the focus of the story in a different direction, you could maybe come up with something that was a bit more unique.
I'm trying to show people that there is a way after every obstacle.
I'm trying to show them that being poverty doesn't stand your way.
Right, we've heard all about the message of your story, but
nothing about your story.
Allow me to take you on a journey. A journey, a 1 minute journey. A journey that is Zuka's journey.
You're left with what is really very much an internal problem, and it's not very easy to portray that on the screen.
The mind of a child is where the revolution begins. This film is about how young learners take charge. This film is about a revolution. They're chanting the word change, 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 change. Change.
Yeah,
it's
these handful of victimized individuals bring me to a forsaken soul.
It's all very poetic. What actually happens in your story?
The young man Craig, who aspires to play in the 2010 World Cup, the 2010 Soccer World Cup, but in his life he faces obstacles,
greater difficulties for him.
Impregnating his young girlfriend.
He has a girlfriend who also falls pregnant,
who has an abortion without his knowledge.
And has an abortion without his knowledge.
Which grade 11 learner wrote this?
So, the girl who was just in here?
That's her.
His name is David. He goes and he's relocated into a richer suburb.
Your character is very, excuse a pun, but black and white. It's like having petrol and wood, and you need a flame.
The stepfather is abusing him. Then Nomsha decided to commit a suicide.
Is that the whole you finished?
Are there any twists or unexpected things?
Nomsha wrote a poem, and then this stepfather doesn't understand the English. And that's why he go to give a class teacher.
Yes. Since you find out that this poem is about him.
That could be a nice little twist.
A class teacher comes to arrest you and offers to pay for her fees. Tandy accepts the offer, not knowing that he has a hidden agenda.
Can I stop you? I want to read your script.
Yes, I also do. Thank you.
Thank you. Goodbye.
The school boy was involved with the teacher because the teacher was able to give him marks.
Is the teacher a man or a woman?
I was gonna ask that.
He likes the other girl and she also likes him, but he doesn't like her back. To get his attention, she spread rumors about him so that thinking that he wouldn't like her.
Sorry, I'm a bit confused now.
Oh, sorry.
Masthola's mother shoot her son right here in the stomach, and then she's like, oh, my son. And then Masthola shoot her mom's dude in the stomach, poof. And then she's like, then poof again. Then they both die at the same time.
I'm a bit confused, but I am interested.
You know, for me, I was like, I'm pretty confused.
But there's a gun in this action, so I'm interested.
Oh, it was very difficult and nervous. I was so nervous.
Very scary. Oh, it was not good.
It was difficult.
2012, they said I did a great pitch.
I am so happy.
It was tough, but it was good.
I was nervous then.
All I can say is that they grilled me.
Yes, no, maybe.
My story is around gossip, and just to show that gossip is also something that can ruin people's lives.
I said yes.
I said maybe.
I also said maybe.
A girl who wants the attention of a guy, but then someone else comes in.
This one excites me.
She spreads rumors about him. Now, thinking she's going to hurt this other girl, she only ends up hurting herself.
It's a yes, it's a maybe. Against that, maybe, which is yes and maybe. So let's take that one.
So he finds out about it, and then he just confronts her and tells her that she didn't achieve anything in spreading the rumors. He just hates her more.
Which one is going to be a more entertaining story?
More fun.
This one is more fun. Death by tongue.
I like the name.
Are we done?
Yeah. Well done.
It's about gossip and hearing all the rumors and actually, like, just witnessing it firsthand.
I'm with Nuran from Victoria Park High School. How does it feel making your own film?
It's very exciting and it's something different. I never thought I'd be doing it, so I'm very excited about it.
Yeah, whereas in real life it doesn't happen like that, but there's certain things that we don't.
What were you and the production team discussing today?
We were discussing our camera shots and our angles and how we'd film it.
Is it necessary to happen in a different classroom?
That's because I want the... because the glass goes like that, and then that's when Sandra passes the paper around.
Okay. Great.
Did you have to rework anything on your story?
Yes, we had to cut a few scenes. It was a bit too long, but otherwise the storyline's all the same.
That needs to be ready, because when we're filming, we don't want to wait 20 minutes while somebody finds a piece of paper and writes a note at 3 times.
I'm with a producer from Victoria Park, Luzuko. What have you learned about producing?
Well, a lot of responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
You have to make sure every single detail, you know, you can't miss out anything.
Victoria Park High School is a co-educational school in the old South End area of Port Elizabeth. Started 68 years ago, and it's built into a fine school now that which caters for about 1,000 pupils from all across both the cultural and economic spectrum. And it's become known as a school that provides an opportunity just for so many people.
How did you come to be part of Nab'Ubomi?
Through the education department, we got a circular come out which explained the project. From there we went to our pupils and announced that there is an opportunity coming up that looks like in the film world. And we were overjoyed when Nuran Madak's script was actually accepted.
What do you think this opportunity means to your children?
Well, one, it gives others who weren't part of this the idea is that if you enter things, if you put yourself out there, there is a good chance of normal people doing great things. For Nuran and her crew, it's a huge step into a world that some people only dream of.
We're doing Nuran Madat's Death by Tongue. Now come join me as we go behind the scenes.
Action!
I do want one more.
This is Nuran Madad, the director of Death by Tongue. What have you done to prepare for today?
We've had lots of rehearsals. Some didn't go according to plan, but we're ready.
Do you have concerns that something might go wrong?
Yes, I do. I'm worried about the break time scenes, but let's hope it goes well.
Sakiwa, tell me, what roles are you playing today?
I'm in charge of the reflector and I'm the assistant of the cameraman, just making sure that lighting and camera setup is okay to take scenes.
This is Viv, who plays the part of Alex. How do you feel acting in front of the camera?
Different, scary. There's like a huge eye staring at you that you're not supposed to look at. And it's just very, it's a different experience.
Take two. Action.
I can't believe you did it.
Don't make such a big deal out of it.
Acting on screen has been a wonderful new experience. I've done a lot of stage work over the years, but to like do the whole retake thing, it's kind of, you've got to have a lot of patience. And it's been a great learning experience for me, I guess.
Action.
There's a lot of things that like, especially there's a lot of equipment and things that I didn't know was going to be there. A lot of things that are, well, yeah, as I said, unexpected. And there's a lot of hassles, like trying not to squint when you've got different bits of equipment coming into your face, not looking at the camera, all the things you're taught not to do. Trying not to do them is actually really difficult.
This is Zuko, the producer, and I want some details here, okay? No one's listening. Now tell me, is Nuran by any chance a slave driver?
Yes, I mean, if you gave her a whip, I'm sure I would have marks on my back now.
So have you guys had any problems during pre-production?
Yes, we did. There was problems with the people pitching up to practice, but you know, we solved it and everything ran smoothly.
Roll it.
Scene one.
With me is Kumbuzo. He's doing continuity and he's also doing clapperboard.
My job entails I'm taking shots, writing down the shots and the scenes, and asking the director for the comments and doing the clapper thingy.
I'm with Leah, who plays Stephanie. Do you think you're giving a good performance?
I think so. Well, I'm trying to portray the character best I can, so we'll see when the final result is shown.
How was it like when the director said action?
I was quite relaxed. It was surprising, actually, because I thought I'd be nervous, but yeah, I enjoyed it. The hardest part was actually running out.
The Baywatch! With me is Joel, who plays Chris. Have you done anything like this before?
I've never done anything on screen before. Basically, I've just done a lot of stage productions, but more on the dancing side of it.
I don't know. Is Chris anything like Joel?
I'd have to say definitely not. Joel is more a type of reserved guy. He's not shy of anyone or anything, and he's basically just himself around everybody.
I'm with Mark in the middle of his setting up for the next scene.
We've done okay today, just I'm a little concerned. It's almost 3:15 now and we've got three more scenes to do basically. So we've got quite a bit of work to go.
I'm a bit worried about my extras because we're after school now. So the only thing is I'm worried about the extras in the classroom scenes, and hopefully the classroom will look full enough to be believable.
Happy?
Yes.
Yes.
Yay.
That's a wrap for this location.
Oh. Oh, everything's gone well so far, even better than I expected. It's been a fruitful experience.
I didn't expect it to go this late, but we did it, and I'm happy with it. I'm very happy.
Which of your cast stood out for you today?
It would have to be Leah Moodley. She played Stephanie. She did the ambulance scene, and when she slit her wrist, she did it excellently. We never rehearsed it, but she fell into place perfectly. I loved it. My highlight was the last scene, because the last scene is my favourite scene, so when it came perfectly together, it was great.
That's a wrap!
You guys have seen the first cut. Do you feel like your dream has been turned into a reality?
Oh, definitely. What I've just seen, it was amazing. I never thought I'd do something like that, but I'm really impressed.
I just want to thank the people from Nab'Ubomi for the opportunity that they've given us, and I also want to thank Nuran for giving me this opportunity. It was a lovely experience for me.
I would have pulled out so many times and Zuka just jumped in and just told me to calm down and he'd sort everything out.
I can't believe you did it.
Don't make such a big deal out of it, man.
What? It is a big deal. You slept with Chris and you broke your virginity with him.
Shut up. But you know, I'm an attractive girl, he's an attractive guy. It just made sense, you know?
Yeah, don't I know it.
Plus, where did you hear about it anyway? I'm pretty sure I never told you.
Mix it. Chris told Charles, who told Gabby, who told Alex, and you know if Alex knows something.
Wait, so you're telling me that by the time the bell rings, the whole school will know? When did she tell you?
This morning.
Well, maybe Chris told Charles, because he's also in love with me. Right? Where the hell are you going?
Would you please sit down and keep quiet?
Sit down and shut up!
Thank you. Are you people ever going to grow up?
No.
Yes, clearly not. Right, this is Stephanie and she'll be in our classes here. Please, people, where are your manners, honestly? Would you like to introduce yourself and tell the class a little bit more about Stephanie?
No, thank you.
She can sit next to me, ma'am.
No, she'll sit next to Alex. And where do the two of you come from?
Principal's office.
On the first day already.
Please, don't concern yourself with other people's business.
No, too late.
Who the hell is that sitting next to Alex?
If you were here on time, you know that this is Stephanie.
Hello, Stephanie. I'm Jess.
Hello.
Just go speak to him, Sandy.
No.
Why the hell not?
What must I say to him?
The two of you must have something to say to each other. You slept with him already.
Shut up about that. I don't want the whole world to know.
They already do.
Huh?
No, nothing, Miss Sandy. Just go speak to him.
Okay. Out.
Something this weekend?
Yeah, sure. No problem. Excuse me.
I hate that cow.
Why?
He couldn't get to her fast enough. What school does she come from anyway?
Yeah, that's what I came to tell you. I was in Mixit this morning and my friend from the school that she was at told me she's involved in a big thing over there.
And what was this big thing?
Apparently, she had an emotional breakdown because she was sexually harassed by a teacher for 2 years. And then at the end of last year, he raped her. And that's when she had the breakdown.
I see.
Did you hear about the new girl, Stephanie?
Yeah, geez, such a slut.
And she has a nerve to act all innocent.
She's even made a move on Chris.
You know, I heard she slept with half the guys at her old school.
Why would anyone be interested in a used car like her? Does Chris know about her past? Because he looks really in love with her.
Actually, I don't think he does know.
Someone should tell him.
Thank you.
wait.
I can't believe Sandra started those rumors about Stephanie.
Yeah. What Sandra did to Stephanie was just so wrong.
Hey, what's that about Sandra doing something to Stephanie?
Don't you know?
No, no what?
Sandra started the rumors about Stephanie.
What?
Yeah, because of you. She was jealous because you were so into Steph.
I don't believe this. Why the hell did you do it? What's wrong with you?
Keep your voice down, you're making a scene.
I don't care. What's wrong with you? You ruined someone's life, all because of your own selfishness. You came so strong onto me. I only did it to get you off my back.
Hidden agenda. Duh.
Is it passing out first?
Come on, cool.
What happened, sir?
Come on, Steph. I just went to the learners called me to the bathroom and there she was, just in a pool of blood. It's amazing, man. I can't believe it. Stephanie, come on. Open your eyes, Stephanie, please.
That's a wrap.